As a consequence of the 27-year-long civil war, which didn't end till 2002, tens of thousands of acres within many of Angola's provinces are now heavily mined. The war was protracted, which resulted in heavy damage to infrastructure across Angola. As a result of this, hundreds of thousands of people were displaced as refugees.
Although the numbers are on the decline, the Halo Trust, quote, still reports thousands of injuries and deaths throughout the sectors and provinces in which they have carried out demining. These numbers will continue unless we clear the remaining mines.
Mine clearance changes communities drastically. It totally transforms them. It gives an impacted and limited community an opportunity to develop. This is due to the increased land which the community can expand into, as well as the new inflow of resources which come with this.
When Princess Diana visited San Antonio in 1997, this area was simply a large minefield, a dangerous barren plain. Now it is thriving, with tarmac roads, housing, schools, new shops. The area is flourishing.
With 261 minefields cleared out of 296, Huambo, in which San Antonio resides, is likely to be the first landmine-free province. This is a key example of the amazing progress which is being made. Although the progress is good, there are two major problems which the Halo Trust is now facing. 7 years ago, their Angolan staff body consisted of 1,100. However, it now sits at just 300. With this low number, mines cannot be cleared at an efficient rate, slowing progress dramatically. It is estimated that it would cost 350 million to clear the remaining mines within Angola. And with the current funding being insufficient, progress is slow.
The Angolan government has set a goal to be landmine free by 2025. And with the increased funding and resources, many Angolan provinces could be seeing the same benefits as Huambo. With the 2025 goal possibly being achieved,